brothers, it's kind of funny you should ask that question because, yeah, right here, the Slickster's been thinking about that one. Let's see, who would win? The Slickster!
Listen, I am the new dude here on the scene, and I got more money than any living human being. Slick is my name, pain is my game. And I am a man of worldwide fame. And let me let everybody here know one thing, that you are looking at a congregation of sophistication, untampered by hesitation, and totally committed to dedication. And let the woo, I can relate to that. I can relate to that. Can you tell me one thing? Where did you come across all your money? Listen, brother, let me tell you something. It's nobody's business where I got my money.
Having an opportunity at this hour to speak with one of the great managers here on the World Wrestling Federation. He is considered the doctor of style, and indeed he is all of that. I could only be talking about Slick, and of course, Slick, as you know, I'm very well aware of your managerial experience. I know about those six gals you managed up in Detroit.
You know, let me tell you something. Are you here to interview or insult?
I'm not here to do any insulting, I can guarantee you that.
Now, you seem to be somewhat an intelligent man.
Well, thank you.
I want to ask you your mediocre opinion.
Yes.
Why in the world would a man who is a former intercontinental heavyweight champion, a man who is respected and cared and loved, adored by these
revered
you shut up and give me a chance, but I got to throw you onion here. Anyway, as I was saying, why would a man like that have the audacity to put his hands on me? One of the most prestigious commodities in professional wrestling today. Have more with no box tag. And this man has the nerve to pick me up and slam me in the floor, all because he doesn't want to have to deal with this man here. But you know, we can't get him right now. So we're going to take the next best thing.
Ended up a couple of weeks ago, body slamming you of all people.
And I want to, the first issue I want to address concerning that matter is that it was an unprovoked attack.
Well, now that's not the way I get it. In all due respect, Slick, apparently you interjected yourself into his match just a little too much.
No. Let me clarify that. I simply tried to issue some instructions to my men, and when I did that, that no good low life had the nerve to try to put his hands on me. Well, I've got a remedy for a problem, and the problem is you, and you're looking at the remedy right here.
Sooner or later, I'm gonna get you. Since you're best friends with the chump, then you can just step right up and take this whooping that's intended for him. Because nobody puts their hands on the Slickster and then walk away and laugh and brag about it. Now then, I'm gonna beat you like a wore-eyed mattress, brother. Myself after this man set you up for me. That's all I got to say.
Well, you know, before we get off on that, brother, let me tell you, lucky the big man will bust you in your mouth right now. It's 483 pounds, and don't you ever forget that. That's right, I'm the mastermind behind this startling transition, because you know, when I acquired the contract of this massive individual, he was like a big 400-pound zombie. The man never talked, he never done nothing but sit around and think of ways to destroy people. But look at him now, he's seen the light, he's vibrant, rejuvenated, and the man is most volatile. Is that right, son?
I want to ask you one question. Have I ever lied to you? I ever let you down? You are on a course, a chartered course, a path that's going to take you right to the doorstep of the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship. And brother, when we get to the door, you understand, that means we're on the front porch. And all we got to do from now is just kick the door down and march right in. And I promise you, you're the next world champion.
Gentlemen, is this the match you wanted all along, or are you going to continue your terrorist attacks? What do you want?
Get out, hoes!
Chill out there while the Slickster lays it all out for you. You see, this is the Slickster third law of wrestling dynamics. See, we are three men, and they are two men, and three men will always be two men. Ergo, presto, we will win.
Now that remains to be seen, Slickster. Now that's the third law of wrestling dynamics. What are the first two laws?
Elementary, my near idiot. You see, first is the law of the jungle. That's it. And then second is the law of the land.
Oh, you gotta be kidding.
Hey, school is at home, you dunce cap. Hey, now it's time for us three beans to go out and beat those two men, cause it's the law.
I can't believe it. Managers to be a factor, to what degree, I don't know.
Come on, if you will, Dr. Style, the Zapper Debonair closed horse. Slick, you got a couple of your men involved in this cart.
Oh, I can't believe that you had the nerve to come out and interfere in this man's match. Don't you know that this man is not to be met with? Well, you're going to find that out, fool.
All right, I thank you. Oh, by the way, Leo Spooner wants to sell you a suit. Slick, here in the loop when you're here over the holidays.
We don't want it.